Hello everyone, Adam here. Today another video from the RTL-SDR playlist, and today I will be showing how to use your TV dongle, Android dongle, to cooperate with RTL-SDR. And in this example, particularly I'll be showing how to listen the aircraft tower frequency, and with the RTL-SDR USB dongle connected to Android TV. So, getting straight to the point, I have some very cheap Chinese Android TV dongle. Mine is named A5X Plus, and it is something with the Rockchip, so I will show it in a minute what is the chip inside. And I'll be using RTL SDR application named SDRTouch, which is free, available for Android devices. Because it's free, it has some features off, but we'll see that in a minute. And to have a more convenient configuration, I have also attached a USB keyboard to this TV set-top box, just to enter the frequencies in the easiest way. Okay, when looking at the Android interface of the TV Android set-top box, I have here integrated Google Play Shop with applications, and I already downloaded two applications. So in my apps, I have plenty of apps, but the one that you should be particularly interested in are the SDRTouch and the driver for this application, which is RTLSDR driver. Okay, just a few words about my dongle. Maybe not the dongle, but the TV Android set-top box. So mine is very cheap. It was about $30. And it is based on the Rockchip 3066, I believe. Oh yeah, you can see it now. It's RK3066, so it's quite, I would say, low powered, but it doesn't really matter because the RTL dongle, it still works with this unit. So it has 4 gigs of RAM, or maybe less, I don't know exactly, I need to check. Let's see, total RAM, so it only 2 gigs, okay? So it's very underpowered, but it doesn't really prevent you from using the RTL-SDR dongle. Okay, let's go to the SDRTouch. So I have it installed. It's a demo version, so it's, I would say, shareware. So you won't be able to use the spectrum analyzer at this point, but we can still use the frequency selection. We can use, I don't know if we can record, but for sure the normal decoding and squelch options should work. So I have already done some presets here just to show you. We'll be listening the aircraft tower, and maybe let's switch this one on and see what it can do. By the way, I'm using a TV remote, and also I'm using a USB keyboard connected to the same device. Yeah, you are now listening to the aircraft tower communication, so there are some guys talking.
We can descend 2000 feet above the airport.
Let's see if we can use the spectrum analyzer. Let's wait for some transmissions.
Sierra Delta, send out to 5000.
Maybe you should try to use the squelch option. I don't know if it's survival. Maybe you know that.
Russell, Argent, Dobre, KLM 68 Kilo, passing 1700 feet, low feet, 7 Golf departure.
As you can see, it's quite usable. You can watch the spectrum and listen to the radio on your TV.
50 to low CKLM, 60 kilo.
Using a simple TV Android box.
240, thank you, KLM, 60 kilo.
We are now listening to the.
Direct Tango 5, 6, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2.
Oh yeah, so it. It works only for 1 minute. I mean, the spectrum analyzer works only for 1 minute unless you buy the unblocking key from the programmer, which costs something like $5. So I do recommend you to buy it. No thanks. We'll work without. So right now we don't have spectrum analyzer because these are still shareware, but we can listen to the aircraft tower nearby. Let's see if we can do a scanning. Someone asked me if we can scan with this app. Okay, scanning means that it will jump through the predefined presets of the frequency that you have already done. So it will not scan through all bands, but it would rather scan to the presets that you have already put here on the left side. So let's switch this one off and let's listen to the aircraft tower. Okay, when we switch off.
I'm 340 to Subic scale, I'm 60 kilo, thank you.
Okay, thanks. Okay, you are now listening to the aircraft tower. So this is.
Descent 4000 feet, QNH 1017, block 46.
Let's see what are the other options in this tool. In the preferences. We have a spectrum size, so depending on the chip you have, on the CPU within this TV Android box, you can select higher or lower quality, as well as you can set some toning step. So if you want to, this is still this radio tower, so it is still decoding it. Long click to change the filter width. You can change the filter width if you have mouse connected, because right now with the keyboard and the TV remote it is quite hard to do it. You can select the width of the filter, so I have 16 kHz now. And that's basically all what you can do with this gains.
Yeah.
I have automatic gain control enabled for the RTL-SDR dongle, which I do recommend for beginners. If you are more familiar with the settings, you can switch this one off and select some gain manually. Okay, let's switch off this app and switch it back again. If we switch this one back, maybe we'll be able to use the spectrum analyzer for a while. For 1 minute. Would this allow us to use it once again? Nope. I think we need to switch this one. Oh yeah, it's on. Okay, I don't know if these are predefined squelch settings or did I. I think these are predefined. The level minus 50 dBm, I believe. Okay, I think that's all for now from this app.
3075, Delta Mike, 3799, Delta Alpha.
I hope you enjoyed the video, so give me a like and subscribe for more such videos. Thank you very much and have a good day and bye-bye.